Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus. Homage to the Venerable Monk Liao
Ming.
Homage to Master Sakya Zhengkong. Homage to His Holiness the 16th Karmapa. And homage to Master Dukten Dorji. Homage to the three jewels of the altar. Homage to the main deity of the group practice this evening, Amitabha Tathagata, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, Mahasthama Prapta Bodhisattva. Simu, Tanzen Katsu, all Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma instructors, Dharma assistants, directors of temples and chapters, all disciples present here and over the internet, and our participating VIPs today, only one. Just one.
驻瑞典兼 Norway 代表
The wife of Ambassador Dong Zhou Liao, the Taipei rep to Sweden and Norway, Dharma Sister Judy.
大家晚安，大家好。
Good evening, everybody. How do you do?
你好，大家好。另外呢，Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas. And Happy New Year.
在还没有讲阿弥陀佛。
Before I'm talking about Amitabha Buddha, there's something that I wanted to say several times, but I forgot about some spiritual responses. On November 10th, I was performing Yellow Jambala Homa at the Rainbow Temple. So check it, was it November 10th when we had Yellow Jambala Homa? And at that time, I saw the treasure mouse spewed out four bags. So you remember? It's been over a month and you still remember there were four bags of money, of dollar bills. And at that time I said that someone will definitely win a lottery. And our Tubuddha school is also a school that has won lots of lotteries, starting with Lianhua Shou Mai that got the first prize in Mega Million. And they have been many more people winning the great lotteries, the power lotto in Taiwan and the Singapore, whatever the name was, in Malaysia, and also the four number lotteries are very easy, but for the Mega Millions in America and the Power Lotto in Taiwan, someone wanted 3 billion.
其中有一个是政府中的第三十一。
Was won by three people, and one of them was a Tribute School disciple. So I saw 4 bags of them, so I know that someone would definitely win. So, until mid-December, I would not expose the name of the person who won the lottery, but someone texts to Simu, and this person had won the Taiwan Power Lotto.
他有参加黄财神
So, the whole family registered for the primary supplicants for the Yellow Jambala. They did not come themselves, but they watched over the webcast. So, from beginning to end,
这个有一天呢, 他心血来潮,
他说, and then one day,
所有,
all of a sudden, they remember that Grandmaster was talking about 4 bags of money. So they went this Taiwan lottery and they won. And they also fax the tickets to Simu to prove that they really won the lottery. And it's a Taiwan lottery. Of course, the person was also from Taiwan. And if I say the person's name, you would know him or her. All of you would know him or her. But I cannot tell you. And he or she will come for the grand ceremony, and that person only notified Grandmaster and Simu. But I don't want to expose the secret, because most people will not want to make it known, because there would be many people and charities appearing at their house after they are known, and that would be troublesome. So, after the Yellow Jambala Homa on November 10th, sure enough, they won the lottery. The whole family registered for the primary supplicants. What else did they fax to us? The amount after tax. And they opened an account.
Oh, 他把领到的钱，那个银行的账户都寄给我们看。他特别开了一个账户。
So they especially opened an account and placed the money in there and then showed it to us. So that showed that the amount is not small. That's why they opened a special account for it. So we just wait for them to come. And of course they would make offering to Grandmaster.
So
that's a great response. And I remember that Singaporean, Fu San should know, someone from Brunei who went to Singapore and bought a lottery and won. And that was 200 million dollars. And he told people, and after that, that was really problematic. Several masters immediately went to Brunei to spread Buddha Dharma. So it's best if you don't make it known. Just tell Grandmaster. And we also have a song artist who won also 400 million NT dollars. 400 million. Before winning the lottery, he often came to listen to the Dharma teaching, but after he won the lottery, he never comes anymore, even when he's invited. So that's not that good. You know, truly the school has won lots of lotteries. And there was a disciple that he got to Grandmaster and told Grandmaster, "I won a lottery." And then he got like a box, a small box, and then threw it over. And almost hit my head. And I thought, what is going on? So that was the offering inside that the box. Even if it hit my head, I wouldn't feel the pain if it were to hit my head. When I open it, then you don't feel the pain anymore. So there were truly many people had won lotteries in Tribhuta school. It's uncountable. Many of them continuing. It's just by chance. Nothing else. It's your faith. It's your luck. Every time I tell everybody, "Oh, let's buy lotteries and we will win." And sure they did, but they won like $10 or $2. But if I didn't make a row about it, then someone won. So when Grandmaster has the vision of several bags of money coming down from sky, then you should pay attention. So that's a response. If I mention the name of this person, most of you would know this person.
在台湾的吗?
in Taiwan.
台湾雷藏寺，你只要讲出这个人。
Anyone at the Taiwan temple, if you mention this person, everybody would know. I cannot continue, otherwise I will expose him or her. And there was another person from Indonesia, Simone. And Simone's mother is here. And Simone sent a text that there is a chapter in Indonesia and the daughter wanted to become ordained as a nun. And the husband's family and the whole family is a very pious Catholics. Oh, and the daughter of the leader of a chapter in Indonesia was about to marry this man from a Catholic family. And then they asked this lady that if you marry this man, then she has to become a Catholic. And then she said, but I'm a true Buddha school disciple, have taken refuge since she was young. So what should we do? And the man's family said, well, if your guru give us some miracles or some responses, then sure, we will let you be. But otherwise, you have to become a Catholic. After they said that night, he or she dreamt of Grandmaster inviting him to have tea. He may have seen my photo, otherwise he wouldn't recognize me. But in the dream, I invited him for tea. So that's called a compromise. So you continue to be a Christian and I continue to be a true Buddha school. That's okay.
And
we true Buddha school are more open-minded and open-hearted. So, even if you want to become a Catholic, it's fine. Why did I say that? Because in Catholicism, they believe in God, in Jehovah, in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is mostly in Christianity. The Bible is divided into the new books and the old books. And for the old books, mostly in Catholicism and in Christianity, mostly they use the new books. So in Christianity, the faith is more toward Jesus Christ, and in Catholicism, toward Jehovah, the Maria, the Saint Mary, and Jesus. So the New and the Old Testament. And I was a Christian too in the past, and we even enshrined Jesus Christ here. And in that Brahma statue next to this, also Jesus. I personally view Jesus as my guru. And higher than Jesus, it was the God, and in Buddhism regarded as the heavenly realm of Buddhism. So it's fine. You can practice the True Buddha School Dharma practices, and you can also go to the Catholic Church and attend the Mass. It's fine, there's no conflict there. So, in terms of religions, True Buddha School is more embracing and encompassing. And we also highly respect the human Buddhism. That's like Confucianism, and there's the heavenly realm of Buddhism, which is like Indra, Brahma, Vishnu. We highly revere them. So the humanly realm, Buddhism, and then heavenly realm, and then Sravaka, Bodhisattva, and Buddha, stages of Buddhism. So Buddhism encompasses all of those. So it doesn't matter where you marry into. Actually, even for the Muslim, they also believe in Jehovah, the same God. So for Catholicism, Christianity, Orthodox, Muslim, they all believe in the same God. It was just being divided by the human beings. Grandmaster had studied Bibles and also the Al-Quran. So inside the Quran, it also talks about Moses and God and Jesus. So actually, all is the same. And Jesus had also appeared for me to see. The same thing today with Amitabha Buddha. You had the group practice of Amitabha Buddha, and Amitabha Buddha had appeared for me to see. You know how big Amitabha Buddha was, the one that I saw? So standing in front of him, I was just even smaller than his toe. So when I looked up, his head was in the sky. I was like an ant in front of his toe. Not only 6 feet Buddha, but huge. Where did I have that vision? It's on the plane from Beijing to Taiyuan. So I saw Amitabha Buddha on a plane, a standing Amitabha Buddha, extremely huge. And that gave the strongest impression. So Amitabha Buddha today had tremendous merits. Think about it. He had many Sambhogakayas and Nirmanakayas. So light bodies and physical bodies and also the Dharma bodies. Therefore, we have 36,119,500 Buddhas with the same name and identification of Amitabha Buddha. Padma Kumara is a light body, the Sambhogakaya of Amitabha Buddha. Guru Padmasambhava too was the Sambhogakaya of Amitabha Buddha. So, even strictly speaking, Ichichoga too was the Sambhogakaya of Amitabha Buddha. If we go deep into it, that's why we will transmit the Dharma of Ichichoga. That's why Amitabha Buddha is extremely great. Do you know who's the great Bodhisattva? Manjushri Bodhisattva. He's an extremely great Bodhisattva. Most people think that he's just one of the eight great Bodhisattvas. Now, let me ask, I want to test.
Danchen Kato. 文殊师利菩萨的净土叫什么净土?
What is the pure land of Amitabha Buddha? I mean, Manjushri Bodhisattva.
好,
don't know. 啊,
清凉山, 清凉山是中国四大名山,
oh, the clear, cool mountain.
在佛经里面是有,
which is one of the four Buddhist mountains in China. That was mentioned in the sutras. But that's his pure land on earth.
But
I want to know about his real pure land. Master Lian Wang, do you know?
金刚窟啊, 好, 应该是很接近, 应该,
that should be pretty close.
我告诉你, 文殊师利菩萨,
let me tell you about Manjushri
Bodhisattva.
When Sakyamuni Buddha was alive, was on earth, he said that the pure land of Manjushri Bodhisattva is like the great ocean.
阿弥陀佛的净土算什么?
That Amitabha Buddha's pure land is considered, and Sakyamuni Buddha made a comparison or analogy. If you pull one hair and then you place the hair into the ocean, and the droplets of water on top of the hair is the pure land of Amitabha Buddha.
你们有看过这个经典吗?
Did you ever read this
没有,
sutra? No.
是阿弥陀佛的净土,
this mentioned in the sutra? No.
文殊师利菩萨的功德无量,
so the merits of Manjushri Bodhisattva is infinite. It's beyond description. And his pure land is as huge, is much bigger than Amitabha Buddha's pure land. We all know that Amitabha Buddha's pure land is already the most supreme, but Sakyamuni Buddha described it like it's just like the water on top of a hair, and the great ocean is the pure land of Manjushri Bodhisattva. So therefore, in his sutra, that's how they describe Manjushri Bodhisattva. So of the eight great Bodhisattvas, Manjushri Bodhisattva's merit is first and foremost. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva is already great, so great. He symbolizes the compassion of all the Buddhas of the three times. And Manjushri Bodhisattva symbolizes the complete wisdom of all the Tathagatas, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. So Manjushri is wisdom and Avalokiteshvara is compassion. And Vajrapani Bodhisattva is the Dharma power, symbolizes Dharma power. Nobody can see Vajrapani Bodhisattva, but a true spiritual cultivator, there would be Vajrapani Bodhisattva standing behind you, especially if you are a tantrika, a tantric practitioner. When we often chant Om Burulanjali, Om Burulanjali, this Buru means Vajrapani Bodhisattva. And he's always behind us. Sakyamuni Buddha once told Sariputra, I will let you see who's behind my back. And Sariputra said, I saw behind Sakyamuni Buddha, there was Vajrapani Bodhisattva standing. And Sakyamuni Buddha said that for each tantric practitioner who had attainments, had fruition, he definitely would have Vajrapani Bodhisattva behind him, standing. And Sakyamuni Buddha asked Sariputra, did you ever see Vajrapani Bodhisattva behind me? And Sariputra replied, no. And by use of the majestic power of Sakyamuni Buddha, he could let Sariputra to see Vajrapani Bodhisattva standing behind him. So in Tantrayana, we call them the three reliances: the wisdom of Manjushri Bodhisattva, the compassion of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, and the Dharma power of Vajrapani Bodhisattva. His Dharma power, his supporter. So for practitioners, you would have Vajrapani supporting you behind you. And Amitabha Buddha, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, and Avalokiteshvara is a Sambhogakaya, an emanation of Amitabha. And Amitabha has infinite, countless light bodies and physical bodies, physical emanations, Sambhogakayas and Nimanakayas, everywhere giving Dharma teachings. That's why there are 36,119,500 Buddhas with the same name and identification of Amitabha. And many Buddhas attain Buddhahood because of Manjushri Bodhisattva. However, Manjushri Bodhisattva always stays a Bodhisattva to save sentient beings. Actually, he's also a Buddha. The more sutras you read, you discover many different things. And Amitabha Buddha is already so great. And Amitabha Buddha is Grandmaster Yidam, and also my origin. And Guru Padmasambhava too. We refer to him as the second Buddha from Udayana or origin. And Sakyamuni Buddha once mentioned in his sutras that in the future there would be Guru Padmasambhava appearing. So he had predicted about Guru Padmasambhava, and Guru Padmasambhava's origin was also Amitabha Buddha, the same as Grand Masters. These are all extremely marvelous. So in this world, there's a great alarm clock, and it's called Mom. If you ask her to wake you up at 7, she would come at 6:30 and tell you, come on, get up, it's about 8, almost 8. Every time when I get up, it's because Simu wake me up. Simu wakes me up. Really. If I just wake up naturally, I don't know what time I would wake up. She always wakes me up every day. When I am sound asleep, she would open my curtains. And then she wakes me up. I cannot blame her because I once said that in one of my past lives, she was my mother. She was my mom. I have said it before, right? She was my mom. So, nothing I can do. Sometimes. No wonders, because she was my mom in my past lives. Since she's my mom, so I have to listen to her. At night, I would help her cover her with blanket, do protection, and bless her so she can sleep well. But in the morning, she's the one that wakes me up. So that's cause and effect. That's his joke. Human life is like an underwear. How comes? So that's what he said here. That you have to accept all kinds of farts. It's not like a, it's not a joke, but when we learn Buddhism, as we all know, there isn't anything as going smoothly or not going smoothly. They're both fine, they're both the best arrangement. When everything is favorable, of course that's good. Everything goes according to your wish. But in the adverse environment or situation, you have to transcend the adversities. So as Buddhists, we have to be like that. Even when it's not favorable, we have to transcend it.
有一句话叫做逆来顺受。逆来顺受。
There is a statement that say that you just take what may come. Whatever happens, you should be able to take it. We always have to think that everything is for the best. Everything is the best arrangement. There's no need to complain because everything is about karma, cause and effect. And if you ponder about karma, everything is fine. Each thing is the best arrangement. There's no need to be so affected by it, to care so much about it. There's no need to grieve over it, to complain. Because once you transcend it, then it's a new door open for you. You need to understand this. Now I will continue to talk about Lamdre. This is talking about the occasion of attainment. So, the occasion of real practice, of spiritual experience, of blessings, and of attainment. So, for the moment, when one achieves the attainment of the four goals, ultimately one attains the attainment of the fruition of the four kayas. This is called being endowed with the occasion of attainment. All this obtained, upheld, and executed according to the ear-to-ear transmission from a supreme guru. So what is the four goals? And what is the fruition of the four kayas? So the four goals about the empowerments. The first one is the vase empowerment, is to permit you to practice the development stage. That's the vase empowerment, or the first empowerment. Simply said, that you are allowed to practice the development stage. That's the first goal. And the second goal is to receive the inner tantra empowerment. It's the practice of the perfection stage. It's the practice of the channels, vital energy, and light drops. That's the second kind of goal. And the third goal is for those who practice highest yoga tantra or Anuttara yoga, to utilize the light drops, inner fire, and qi inside your body to generate the clear light radiance. The light drops can increase, the inner fire can rise, and the vital energy or the qi can open all the channels and flowing smoothly. So to permit you or to allow you to practice the Anuttara Yoga, the highest yoga tantra, and that is called the wisdom empowerment, which is the third kind of empowerment or the third kind of permission. And the fourth or last one is that you have attained the fourth empowerment. And we can say that's the empowerment for the completion or perfection empowerment. So four kinds of empowerments. For the development stage, perfection stage, highest yoga, empowerment, and then the great perfection. And after having attainments of this four goals, then you would attain the fruition of the four kayas or four bodies. The first one is the fruition of the Dharma body or Dharmakaya. Second is Sambhogakaya or light body. The third fruition is Nirmanakaya or physical body. And the last one is the attainment of the fruition of the true body. So we call it the four kinds. So once you have the attainments, you have these four bodies: physical body or Nirmanakaya, light body or Sambhogakaya, Dharmakaya, and then the combination of the three is called the true body or true kaya. So this is the occasion of attainment. All this are obtained, upheld, and executed according to the ear-to-ear transmission from a Supreme Guru. So Milarepa has one of his hands to his ear, meaning that he performs the ear-to-ear transmission. That is his ear-to-ear transmission. There's the incessant or inexhaustible river of empowerment. Because when your spiritual cultivation is put into real practice, then the blessings is continual. And you have spiritual experiences, you could sense, you could feel the blessings of the Yidam. And then the unfailing blessing continuum. So the blessings, the inner blessings, and the blessings from the sky, and blessings from Dakinis. I often talk about remote empowerment. What is remote empowerment? Why Grandmaster is able to perform the remote empowerment? Someone wanted to take refuge and he's living in Mongolia in a very faraway place. And in order to receive a real empowerment in Seattle would be very difficult. And he has a faith, a strong faith. When he faxed his registration form, when Grandmaster took a look that this person is registering for refuge initiation, I would invoke Dakinis and I would have the Dakinis to transport the empowerment water to fly, the Dakinis carrying the empowerment water to fly to Mongolia and to bless him. Then that's a refuge initiation empowerment. So empowerment is the same as blessing, initiation. So we utilize the Dakinis, we ask the Dakinis to empower this disciple who is intending to receive the remote empowerment. So if you can do it, then you are able to perform the remote empowerment or initiation or blessing. Grandmaster is often surrounded by Dakinis. In my room, I have the Vajrayogini and Vajravarahi. Vajrayogini, Vajravarahi, and the three heavenly goddesses, Svetara, the forearm, Chandrasik, Magic Lapdron, Golden Mother, the greatest Golden Mother, all inside my room. So I asked them to perform the empowerment and blessings. So at the same moment, people have the sensation. Why did I mention about Mongolia? Because there was a disciple in Mongolia asking for a remote empowerment. When he performed the great prostration toward the east, all of a sudden, there was water sprinkling on his head. It was not raining. No rain. So he truly felt it. As he was making the prostration, he felt a few drops of water on his head. There was no leaks on the roof, and it was not raining. How could there were drops of water on his head? And then immediately he told us that he felt that spiritual experience from the remote empowerment, that sensation. So when I bless the letters, it's the same. When I give the blessings to the letters here, and they were sent out, and the disciples over there, before they received the letter, or the day before they received the letter, they had a dream, or they heard as a voice that Grandmaster told them that your letter is here, and the second day they would get the letter from the postman. This often happened. So today we were talking about the occasion of attainment. Someone often went to the temple for marriage. You know, the old man under the moon. And one night, he had a dream, and that old man under the moon told him, please don't come to my temple anymore, there's no need, there's no use. You know why? There's no use. Because for many people,
多的话, 他自然就会多, 因缘少,
if they don't have the the faith or the destiny, then naturally they would have it. If they don't, doesn't matter, even if you ask. So this old man under the moon would make marriage happen, and it's all for the good marriages. According to what I know, Grandmaster would know if you have a marriage prospect or not from your face. Because there's, we call it the peach blossom on your face, which is like the romantic inclination. That means you still have marriage prospect. But if you don't have that on your face anymore, it doesn't matter how hard you ask for it. So it is destiny. It is predestined. Talking about flowers,
我实在不懂它的这个象征,
I really don't understand this. This is from the internet.
它有很多东西耶,
lots of things here. Oh, the language of flowers. Do you know what this flower means?
彼岸花是曼陀罗花, 那就是莲花啦。
What is this flower?
是什么花?
曼陀花, it's like flower from the other shore. What is that?
有毒的。
叫做彼岸花。他说彼岸花是代表死亡。 It represents death.
哦，原来是这样子。所以，我从来没有看过彼岸花。
I've never seen these flowers.
彼岸花你们都知道，我不知道哎。
And you know this flower? Amazing.
彼岸花代表死亡。
It represents death.
那午夜花代表厕所。
This is like red spider lily.
我知道啦，你知道卫生纸就是午夜花吗？
And the May flower. It's actually a tissue paper, so it symbolizes toilet.
那么喇叭花代表什么呢?
And
morning
glory.
喇叭花代表吹牛,
represents boastful, boasting.
吹喇叭.
Like blowing on the horn. Morning glory, like bellflower.
菊花代表什么呢?
And chrysanthemum.
就是代表已死。你知道那个,
represents death.
我们
already
在那个殡仪馆 弄的都是菊花嘛。
Like in the during funeral, you use chrysanthemum, which represents is already dead.
天花吗? 啊, 这里写着, 乱花就是代表没钱。
So small pox represent that you're sick. And then if you
a
free spending, it represented no money. So these are all symbols. Like in Lamdre 2, there are just lots of symbols.
这个也算笑话吗? 我讲给大家听。老伯被我辱骂。
This is a joke, right?
怎么道歉都没用?
I upset my wife, and doesn't matter how I apologize, it's no use. She was really upset and angry and said that I want to buy a really expensive thing. And I thought, well, as long as it can resolve the calamity by spending money, it's good. I said, okay, I'll accompany you to go. It turned out she bought a washing board.
什么意思?
What does this mean?
还是你们聪明?
So you're smart. So you need to kneel on the washing board. That's also a symbol, right? Nowadays, nobody is selling that washing board. But you still need it if you wash by hand. I think, as Buddhist practitioners, we should be very open-hearted, very open-minded, very open and clear, and carefree and open-minded, that our heart is wide open, not narrow-minded. You know, I see lots of things in this world that everything are so narrow, but to practice Buddhism is to learn to be no self. When self or I don't exist anymore, then you would be like the sky. Only this is called the Buddhist study or Buddhist practice. But if you are still having boundaries or restricted by this I or self or ego, then you would not be able to transcend. So most importantly is your heart has to be wide open, truly boundless, that you can embrace everything, you can encompass everything. Anything is fine. Everything is the best arrangement. And even more, if you can reach the realm of non-abiding, that would be the best. Like in the Diamond Sutra, it's mentioned about non-abiding, that your heart and mind is like the cosmic space. You have to learn, you have to train to be like this. But if the more you go, the more restricted, limited, and narrow you become, then it's easy for you to get off the proper path. Then you are not like a Buddhist. You cannot think that true Buddhist school is the best and the rest are bad. You should not think like that. There are so many knowledgeable spiritual friends. Don't be so self-centered. Then you will have attainment. That's what I would like to remind you. Om Mani Padme Hum.